In Ableton Live, you can freeze a track to render it into a new audio clip. I'm going to walk you through the process of using Live's freeze functionality. In Ableton Live, you can freeze a track to render it to a new audio clip. Freezing tracks is a great way to reduce stress on your computer's CPU. In this project, I have lots of instruments and effects on this channel. As you can see from the CPU meter, it's placing a fair amount of stress on my computer. Let's freeze this track to give my computer a little breathing space. After clicking on the track to select it, I can right-click on a PC or control-click on a Mac and choose Freeze Track from the pop-up menu. Live will then overlay this track in blue so that I can easily see it has been frozen. As you can now see, the amount of CPU Live is using has been dramatically decreased. Even though this track is frozen, I can still use Live's mixer functions, for example, the track volume and panning, as well as launching and stopping clips. If the track I freeze has clips in both session and arrangement views, Live will freeze both of them. In the arrangement view, Live will include any audio that occurs at the end of the last loop of my frozen clip. A typical example of this is time-based effects, like delay and reverb tails. This is represented by the cross-hatched pattern on the resulting extra clip. You can also freeze tracks that include effects with their sidechain function enabled. This will capture the sidechained effect in its current state. In this track, I've used a compressor device to duck the audio via a sidechain from my kick drum. After freezing the track, we can still hear the sidechaining in action. I can commit my frozen tracks to a new audio clip by selecting Flatten. If I have frozen a loop, Live will render two cycles of the loop to account for any changes in the effects I'm using. Finally, I can unfreeze my track to return it to the state that it was originally in before I froze it.